Good morning, students. Today we are discussing about the chords in E. There are several chords at the lower level. We have got the lower level chords, middle level, that's high chords, and supreme level. So that's what we have to notice. Only one at the apex level in the supreme level. So many high chords are there, so many distinct chords are there. That's what we are going to discuss. The chords that most people interact are called subordinate or distinct chords at the distinct level. Most of the cases start with the distinct level or tahsil or distinct level of chords. They are the lower of part of the judicial system. Okay, there are different levels of chords in our country. So there are different levels. So the district level, state level, then national level. This is the division. Okay, the courts are. District courts are presided over by the district judge. There are judges in the district court. There are district judges there. Sessions judge or district judge there. So a high court is the highest court of any state. So any decision. Any decision that is taken in the district judge, if we are not happy, we are unsatisfied with the decisions of the high court or the district court, we can go to the high court. If the high court decision we are not happy, we can go to Supreme Court. For the Supreme Court, there is no international court. The decision stops. Further, nothing happened. Any decision taken by the Supreme Court, that's the final. We can, once a decision is taken by the Supreme Court, we can give a review petition asking the court, please, I am not happy with the judgment. Please try to reconsider my case. If the court thinks it can reconsider, so reconsideration, we can give a review, which is known as review, review, again view the thing. That is possible. They just can, if they are feeling to listen, they can listen. That's all. Otherwise, nothing can be done. If it's a death penalty and so on, we can go to president asking for a mercy petition. It's asking the president not to hang. That is possible. That is the president's decision. No, it is an executive, not a president. President of the government will decide. That is it. Okay. The Supreme Court is located in New Delhi and is presided over by the Chief Justice of India. The highest post in the judicial system is the Chief Justice of India. I'll show you the photo of us. Okay. The decisions made by the Supreme Court are binding on all other courts in India. All other cities, all the citizens as well as courts. If any decision is taken by the Supreme Court, that is applicable to the district court, high court, everybody. Same. They cannot change the judgments of the Supreme Court. Nobody can change it. Only Supreme Court can change the decision of Supreme Court. Lower court cannot say, oh, that the Supreme Court judge was wrong. I am correct. I should know. Supreme Court judgment can be changed only by the Supreme Court. By when somebody gives a review petition. Okay. We have an integrated judicial system. Means that decisions made by the higher courts are binding on the lower courts. No excuse. Any decision made by the High Court, it should be accepted. Or the district judge can go to the Supreme Court or higher court and say, I am not happy with the decisions. If the High Court has decided, district judge can go to Supreme Court. But Supreme Court has decided, finish matter is over. Nothing. Okay. Appellate system exists in India. Appeal. Appellate system is we can appeal any decisions till Supreme Court. Okay. Many times we can appeal also. That's why I told review petitions. If single bench has given a decision, you are happy and have a single one judge, then you can have two judges. If the two judges are decision, you can have multiple judges, you can request. But that also court should decide, not your own request. Okay. Your own request is compulsory, court should hear also. For access, it can be reviewed. That's it. This means that a person can appeal to a higher court if he believes that the judgment passed by the lower court is not just. If the district court has passed a judgment, I am not happy with the district court judgment, I can go to high court. If the high court judgment also I am not happy, I can go to Supreme. That's appellate jurisdiction. Appeal can be given against the decision of. Okay, that's it. That is what happens. In any system it is. Okay. Every governmental system, higher authority, going to higher authority. Higher authority is the in judiciary higher authority Supreme Court. Further nothing else. This stops there. Then high courts were first established in the three residency cities in India, Calcutta, Bombay and Madras. This was the first high courts in India. It was established in 1862. Okay? Then currently there are 25 high courts in India. At present, 25 high courts are. You know, states are more, but high courts are less. We will come to that. Punjab and Haryana share a common high court at Chandigarh. Chandigarh is the capital of both the states. So they are having only one high court, that is Chandigarh High Court. That is for Punjab. So naturally, two states are, I told you, number of states are more. So it has come down. Then Goa is attached to Maharashtra High Court, Bombay High Court. Another place is attached to Guwahati High Court. Mizoram also attached to Guwahati High Court. And Nagaland High Court. All these states are attached to Guwahati High Court. Does not have their own High Courts. So Goa is not having, Andhra Pradesh, Mizoram, Nagaland. All these states are not having their own High Courts. They are attached to other High Courts. Andhra Pradesh is the latest High Court that is located in Andhra Pradesh, Amaravati. It's the latest High Court that was formed on the 2019 January 1st. That's the latest High Court in India. After that, no more High Courts are formed. Okay, so Andhra Pradesh was there. Andhra Pradesh, it was Hyderabad, there was already High Court was existing. That High Court is Telangana. Okay. And then Andhra Pradesh Supreme High Court is located in Amaravati, expected to be capital, there may be shifted also. News is there, just shifted, but there is this one located in Amaravati. That is the present situation. Okay. Then, different branches of the legal system, criminal law, what is criminal law? Deals with the conduct or acts that the law defines as offense, for example, theft, harassing a woman to bring more dowry, murder, any of these kind of cases. So, if you stealing something, it will become as a criminal case. Harassing, attacking somebody, beating somebody, it will become as a criminal case. Then, dowry, asking dowry somebody, it is a criminal case. Killing somebody, of course, is known as a criminal case. It usually begins with the lodging of an first information report, FIR. If somebody is doing something to you, you can go and complain to the police station. That's FIR, first information report. Then FIR will be registered, then cases will be going in. After cases are studied, the police will submit the case to the court. Then the argument starts. Then somebody, the advocate will be there telling that my client has not done, somebody else might have done the mistake. So they will argue, and if it is court finds that the FIR or the case that is presented by the police is correct and this person has done, it will be given punishment. The lower courts given punishment, he can go to upper court telling that the lower court has given a wrong judgment. So police who invest the case claim which a case is filed in the court. If found guilty, the accused can be sent to jail and also can be fined. That is the judge decides what should be done according to the crime justice. Then civil law means example disputes relating to sale of land. Somebody tells I don't get my money for selling the land, or I don't want to sell my land. They are asking for lower or less money. Something like the dispute with the selling of land. Purchase of goods, so by purchase of goods, the shopkeeper has not given me good material, or he took me more money than the required amount. All those things, that is the purchase of goods. Quality is not good. Rent matters, if I am taking a house, rent and so on. Divorce, all those comes as a civil case, civil law. A petition has to be filed before the relevant court by the affected party. So, that just goes to judgment. Court and file a case that this has to be done. My land is taken or my dispute, all those things can be there. In the arranged matter, either the landlord or tenant can file a case. Means if I have given a house to somebody for rent, I have become the landlord. If I have taken a house from somewhere, if I have taken a house from Mr. Ramarao, I have to give him rent. So I become tenant. If I am giving the house to somebody, I become the landlord. So anyone can, because the tenant is not ready to give more rent, then the landlord can go. And if the landlord is asking more money, the tenant can go to the court. The court gives the specific relief asked for. Whatever the thing, the court gives the order. For instance, in a case between landlord and the tenant, the court can order the flat to be vacated and pending rent to be paid. If the tenant is not paying the rent, he is showing some, you know, I will not pay, then he has gone to the court. What would say? The tenant should vacate the house and give the rent to the landlord. So all those things that depends upon the case, how it is. Okay, so these are the high courts. Different high courts of India. This is Madras. This is Bombay. Okay, so that is some things we have studied today. Thank you very much.